Welcome you all to the day 3 afternoon session. I welcome afternoon's resource person, Mr. Navaneethan. Hello everyone, welcome to day 3 afternoon session on IoT security challenges and applications. Now I am glad to introduce our resource person briefly. He has a great and versatile research and industrial experiences in the field of cybersecurity. Sir, are you there, sir? Navaneethan, sir? Are you there? May I hear your voice? For a while. Am I audible? Anyone could text me, am I audible? First I want to ensure, because I switched over from speaker to headphone. Yeah, thank you. Hello everyone, welcome to day 3 afternoon session on IoT security challenges and applications. Now I'm glad to introduce our resource person briefly. He has a great and versatile research and industrial experiences in the field of cybersecurity. Mr. Navaneethan did his engineering in electronics and communication engineering, masters in information communication engineering, currently pursuing PhD in cybersecurity from Puducherry Central University, Puducherry. He has currently 17 plus industrial experience. He worked in Capgemini India, Deloitte, and currently working in PayU as a senior vice president, CASO, since December 2018, Bangalore. Mr. Navaneethan carries a deep passion and love for the cybersecurity space. He is working as a senior vice president, chief information security officer, and head of IT at PayU, Naspers Group, Bangalore. He has extensive experience and expertise in areas such as CASO, CAO operation, strategic cybersecurity account management, enterprise security and risk management, cyber emerging technology, cyber threat landscape, hacking and countermeasures, business development, cybersecurity business operations, program management, and people leadership. He is result-oriented and effectual leader with proven ability in driving results to the benefit of clients. He had demonstrated on launching new services for the various niche cybersecurity areas. He also led a team on projects related to cybersecurity with the members who are distributed across different global locations. He has demonstrated on creating a cybersecurity strategy and roadmap to achieve clients' business objective by thought leadership, achieving highest level of customer satisfaction, delivering cost-effective industrialized delivery as well as quality in his primary concern. Quite often, he is invited as a speaker by leading universities, colleges, ISACA, DSCI, and leading forums both in India and across the globe as well. He has published several cybersecurity technical papers in international journals. He is holding 21 cybersecurity industry leading certifications. He is mentoring several startup organizations, different universities, and industry as well. He is SIG Council member of NASSCOM Cybersecurity Future Skill, Government of India. He played a vital cybersecurity role in MNCs like Xerox, Capgemini, Deloitte. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to all. Sir, we are keen to hear your intellectual insights. I would like to request Mr. Navaneethan to start the session. Welcome you, sir. Sir, am I audible, sir? Sir, again, I request all of you wait for a couple of minutes. Sorry for the inconvenience. Our resource person have joined again, got disconnected and connecting back again. Sorry for the inconvenience. Couple of minutes, we will be starting the session. Thank you. Welcome, sir. Actually, during the disconnect, I have completed your profile reading. I'm so sorry. I have introduced about yourself and your versatility. Welcome you for accepting our invitation and being with us for the third day, day three session. Thank you for your acceptance and being with us. Welcome you, sir.
Amazing. Thank you so much for having me here. It's my honor and privilege to be, you know, part of your forum and deliver the speech.
Yes, sir. I will stop sharing it. You can start with your presentation, sir.
Sure, I'll do that. Is it visible now?
Not it, sir. I have stopped sharing. Yeah, it is visible, sir. Only we may need to go with the presentation mode. That's it, sir. Yeah, perfect, sir. Thank you.
Amazing. So your voice is clear. The slide is perfect. And
Perfect. Everything is perfect. Goes well.
Amazing. Amazing. Thank you. Great, fellow member. Thank you so much for being here. I understand you have a tight schedule, but however, you made mind to learn something new, or maybe whatever you have, it just you wanted to share it back. Always, I take it as a mutual the discussions. Most of my discussions, most of my presentation, it goes as two-way communications. But during this remote sessions, like if you open. It goes on the different way directions. So that's why where we do this deliverable. But of course we'll take a break in between, or as and when you have any other stuff which needs immediate clarity, where we can get it addressed, or end of the sessions so where we can have a Q&A and then close it up. This goes close to 2 hours, but let's see how things will move around, where we can extend or we can finish it up yearly, whichever way you feel where we can plan and then take it forward. Amazing. Lakshmi has given the overall intro, but however, just it's a one snapshot, my profile, where I have close to 18 plus of experience into cybersecurity. I worked in the company called Capgemini, Deloitte, Sunstream, as well as the PayU. from the end to end, where I can say I was completely into cybersecurity. I can say bottom to bottom and cybersecurity from where I was doing my college and then post it out to each and every organizations. But I have worked as a CISO at the same time. I have been managed a practice where we have close to 800 plus people from end to end across the global, where we are able to deploy and manage the projects across cybersecurity, because cybersecurity has many domains where we are able to handle and then take it forward. But I'm part of NASSCOM. So the NASSCOM is NASSCOM. They have multiple programs. Mm-hmm. One of the program called the Future Skill, where we have a board member of 8 people, where we are framing syllabus for the entire country, where close to 1 million shortage of workforce, where we are developing and working out to roll out across India to have more resources, to have more the potential people to bring on cybersecurity side. I have close to 20 plus certifications. Moreover, I'm also a part of your community. Right now I'm pursuing my PhD. Because where every conference where I present multiple new topics and all things, then I thought taking into some pattern and other things, and also right now just I'm working on the PhD. Parallelly, we are working on some pattern also. This is a small snapshot of my profile. If you want to connect professionally, you can connect on the LinkedIn and then take it forward. Amazing. So let's get a session. Always know if you who are all 75 people, 75 professionals who are joined, they may be a professor, lecturer, HODs, or maybe a student, or maybe different stuff actually. But ultimate stuff is they wanted to learn the entire things, right? So that's the purpose we have. We want to learn new things. That's what we are part of the stuff. That is the first step where we have taken actually. So the Warren Buffett it's like a big giant. In fact, into a lot of investments he has done in India as well as the Global Forum. The best investments you can make is an investment in yourself. The more you learn, the more you will learn. So the yearning always, let's not focus on the yearning. Always let's focus on the the learning. So learning by default will lend you in the learning stuff. So that's what the continuous learning will help you to take the next level wherever you are and then where you want to be. So I think we are on the same page. That's what we are here, right? Mutually we are sitting and spending time. Not only the money, right? The spending time also is on the bigger way where we have to take care of the entire a few hours sitting and focusing. That is a bigger one, right? The money can be replaced, but the time may not be replaced. So that's why the best investments you can make is invest in yourself. That's purely on the learning, always in the track, and we are good to grow. So in terms of cybersecurity, always very strongly I focus, the Albert Einstein statements. I'm neither clever nor especially gifted. I'm only very, very curious. He's a giant, right? He invented a lot of stuff, actually. But ultimately, his point of view also, I'm curious. Really, I wanted to know what's happening on the systems, what's happening on in an overall eco environment. Why not this? Why this? Now, that kind of curiosity he has, purely, I also agree with the statement, specifically on cybersecurity, we need a lot of curiosity from end to end, how much curiosity you have, that way you do the penetrations and then you may go up in your ladder. So that's why curiosity is very important. Maybe you would have noticed, right? The kids will have more curiosity where we cannot control. But as a parent or maybe as a elder, we may have an answer, but continuously you can't keep feeding them. So the kids will have more curiosity as well as they don't have much in terms of the stage fear or maybe in terms of the ambience or in terms of environment, which needs to focus. Whatever they have, they wanted to throw it in the right forum or the right place, wherever they are. So that's the way, let's have this curiosity, which play very significant in the character, in the human, I can say, not only in cybersecurity, most of the places. Yeah, it is a very unique, the personality, unique character If you don't have, also let's have that curiosity. Always we love it, right? We wanted to know what my manager is earning, right? We wanted to know what my neighbors is buying. So that's a curiosity on the different aspects. But this curiosity is in terms of learning, in terms of investing your time, in terms of getting things, you know, the better and better. That can be, you know, we can take it forward. Amazing. Since overall this structure, how I made it is, I have given in terms of how this IoT, of course, so, you know, you all joined, you know, this IoT, how it is designed and formatted and all the steps. But however, let's do the little bit dive on how cybersecurity play very significant steps on the, you know, the IoT area. Not only IoT, another focus area also, but IoT is the key things where today we are going to touch upon, and we will, you know, take it forward. Here we have a two way of, you know, the profiles, right? One is a defender and then offender. Like, you know, if you take army also, we'll have a two way. Whether it is in India, Indian army is sitting, so they are fully defending. And then defending against offending of Pakistan or China. But similarly, the Pakistan soldiers, they are in the defending mode, like to, you know, what are the offense stuff, it comes from the, you know, other regions. So that's the way everyone have their own statement, everyone have their own way of understanding, like what they're acting, that's genuine. What they're acting, that's correct, right? So that's the way where we have a cyber attack profile where we have given us a 5 profile. One is recreational, recreationals and criminal, activist, organized crime and state sponsors. So recreationals, it's like moreover, we know that, right, the door is open. You know, we try to just, you know, push the door and see that what it is, how it is. You know, that's, you know, recreational stuff. It's for the fame. That's for the, you know, the small happiness for that time actually, right? That's the way just we wanted to, you know, do that. That kind of activity is purely for like students level, they do it. Then criminal, like on the bigger level organization, let's say they have some antivirus product or they have some other applications product which they wanted to protect. They will have a team really who can create the virus, and then there is a separate team who can, you know, put all the countermeasures. So moreover, red teaming, blue teaming, where they'll be sitting together, but independently they do that actually. Themselves create a virus, but themselves they have to find out the overall, you know, antivirus for the respective product. As well as they have a separate red teaming, like in terms of a hacker, but it's with purely for the purpose of to fill the gaps or to address this gap, whatever they have it. So that's kind of things they will have. That's a purely it comes under the criminal. Then hacktivist, you know, the hacktivist is where they have a targeted, you know, attacks. If you want to bring down anything specific to the department or organizations, or maybe emotionally we are connected within the city or within organization, we want to take any revenge. That kind of stuff, it goes with, you know, hacktivists. Let us take in Twitter, we are saying Google got hacked, but it's not hacked, but just the informations, right? But what are the information it is going on the Twitter or the social media, but it's a message is passed. Single Google is hacked, but it's not the real case. So how many people will do the deep dive and then understand, you know, where it is hacked, how it is hacked and all the steps at all. So that's the way the hacktivist, you know, played it. And the next very important stuff is in terms of, you know, organized crime. This organized crime is, if you see the dark web and then in terms of the services, if you want to beat someone, right? Earlier, if you see the movie, there is separate gang, right? If you pay the money, you know, whatever the hand you are showing to the person, so whatever you want to do, they will do it. The same way it's organized crime, it's on the digitally, it's happening now. You know, there are a huge number of organizations. They are sitting over there. Only thing is you have to give a company name and then what level of attack where you have to create. You make you know, the ransom amount to them, and then from there they can do a lot of attacks and then bring down. It's very simple, right? You have a CEO, CFO. You want to do the follow-up of, let us take a CEO. from an office CEO standpoint, we may know very little things, right? When the board meeting is happening during that time, we may have a discussion. And then maybe in other way, we may know a little bit about his character and all the things, but we may not know, all the stuff or whatever it is, it has happened. But if you do the tracking of the senior profile 24/7, we'll get to know his other side also, right? What he does, where he's interested, maybe in terms of drinking or in terms of taking property or he's spending time somewhere else. We know that the complete stuff, right? So that's why if you monitor 1 week, we'll get to know any people, where to start, where to end, and then how they are doing their entirety. So that's a very organized crime, it's happening. It's across, that's what it is, all the hacking, whatever, maybe upcoming slide, you can see the lot of organized crime which is happening, which is moving across all the sectors. State sponsored. What's a state sponsor? Now, the name itself, it says somebody sponsoring this program. It's really for the hacking. The people will do the sponsoring. Is it possible or not? Absolutely possible. So if you take Australia, China, specifically in China, each and every state, they have a separate funding to groom their team in terms of to ready for the cyber war. That's what you would have seen, right? A number of close to 158 applications which belongs or wanted by the Chinese organization or Chinese originated organization. The data flow. Similarly, they have created an application, all the things, but it comes when they install on the Indian environment. Right? It may be a government officials, it may be an educational institute, it may be a research institute, but everybody will start using that application. The same way we can track the call, right? Let us take somebody's working on a defense. He's using TikTok. Or he's using some other app, whatever the, I don't want to name it, but he's using some app. Through that, he specifically, from outside, we can see this app is for some other XYZ purpose, but may not be the case, right? They may tap this entire conversations, whatever, you have it. I believe you are aware, right, of the entire your mobile conversations in terms of, voice call, video call, your overall transaction, all the things can be tracked. It's just a matter of a minute what they have in terms of applications. Already we have given consent. Whenever you want to install it, will ask you whether you want to have access to phone, you want to have access to microphone. So that way we wanted to use it in all the way actually. So that's why it goes in the long way. That's from sponsorship actually. You can take and then move it forward. So this is, we are going to touch all the five parameter, how it's happening and all the way actually from end to end and then how it moves. But now the street sponsors things is, it's really hitting most of the organization at country level. It may not be a organization to organization. It's going on the very bigger in terms of hit and then it's going on there. So you know that, right? If you take earlier physical war, maybe 2011 attack, Twin Tower, or maybe World War One and World War Two, we lost of human life. We lost a number of property as well as infrastructure. It is gone. So in terms of Japan, if you take Hiroshima, Nagasaki, or maybe Twin Tower, or whatever it is, Manhattan, it's all the physical war, right? They want to physically, they want to destroy your listening and they wanted to gain the the benefit, like in terms of slowing down your market and all. That's like a physical war. So now what we're happening is all the COVID-19, it's a, the bio war, right? They brought down that economy down. It's not only on the specifically physical, right? If you want to bring down the economy, I can do that in any way. So that's about, it's a bio war. It's like last 6 months. So I can say across the world, it's close to 8 months. But India, I think from March onwards, we started to get that heat. So the bio war is the second one. Third one is cyber war. Cyber war is, it's an internet well connected from end to end, right? Really, if you wanted to have a overall, bring down any other, let us take a, New Zealand Stock Exchange or India Stock or US Stock Exchange, right? They are the one trading, they are the one making who is doing great and then who is not doing great, right? So that's the way we can make a lot of stuff actually. So from that standpoint, they have created, from end to end, and how we can do the countermeasures, how we can make attack, how we can, move forward. So that's the way the physical war and bio war, cyber war, it's all three is well connected. Ultimately, they are bringing down the country economy or organization economy or the individuals, whoever it is. So of course, we have experience on all three, right? I mean, the physical war, in terms of in our border, we have come across bio war. Everyone is going through now. Cyber war, of course, you might had it, but still it's happening on each and every mobile. We will discuss in upcoming slides. Amazing. So if you see here, I have given snapshot of all the attack which has happened across the world, across organizations. Each one have a different unique business unit, and the nature of business is absolutely not different. You may think the Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn, they are very robust. They don't have any other flaw or something actually. So we can get into the very bigger way actually. So from that standpoint, it's not only specific to the nature of business, not only specific to the organizations, but where we have the bigger, the enforcement from end to end across the world actually. Because close to 420 million record it has been leaked. Luckily, there's no credit card, debit card detail, but it has your the profile name and your user ID, your password, just all those stuff. So which was leaked out. It's in the 420 million. It's a huge, right? It's like off our Indian populations. I can say, of course, we are 1.3 billion, but however, it's close to that. That level of account it got hacked. So how about this one or two account? It is possible, but if it is touching this in terms of millions of records, then something wrong, right? So that's the way the integrations play the major role. Wherever we are integrating these applications or the systems, it connects and then take it forward on the bigger way. If you see overall, I have given us a different sectors also. Like if you take a Marriott hotel, how the Marriott hotel hacked, and then what is the benefit of having a Marriott hotel in terms of sniffing or in terms of hacking this data? So if you take a Marriott hotel, we may think it's like a hospitality, like the people will come and go and they will stay, right? What we can get it. So in terms of hotel, now we are going into the multiple sectors because of IoT. One is what are the card they are swiping, right? When they are logging into these systems, always the courtesy, that is a mandatory process, they have to swipe the card. That will have all the information because that will validate whether what are the card you have that has a valid card. Whether it is a Master, Visa, you have enough balance, all the things, it will check and then keep you, it will not build it, but it will keep you ready. So once you are doing the checkout, it will take the bill and then it will go off. So whenever they are swiping out, the card, actually it stores all the cards into the local buffer and then move to the, Visa, Master, or whoever the payment gateway who have authorized. So they have ignored, right? Always the hotel people, the receptionist, they will not much focus on this electronics items. If anything goes wrong, they will call the respective people to rectify. So that's why they have hacked close to 383 million, the data, including credit card and debit card. Think about that. If you have a one or two credit card at itself, we can buy a number of stuff based on the credit limit. 383, it's all in Europe as well as India and then the US. So the entire network got hacked actually. It's a 383 million, it's a huge, right? In the last few years, whatever you have, it's the entire things, it's gone, out of that actually. And the next is Microsoft. Always Microsoft, it's a well-known from, the end-to-end in terms of, because they are in the industry, it's more than 25 years. That they have created MS Office, your operating systems. Without them, really, we can't operate, right? User-friendly, all the interface and all. They have 14 years of their customer records. 14 years, whatever they had communications for the customers, the entire record it got leaked, actually close to 74 GBs. It's on the 215 million record it got leaked out. So why I'm consistently I'm touching all bigger giant is always we'll have that kind of mindset, right? During COVID-19 also, we had, boss, whatever virus you have, US will have a medicine. But really, they don't have it, right? So that's a different perspective, you know, they brought into that everyone mindset. Now, we know that our, even the COVID, what are the situations, we know that even US also, they have some limitations, right? What are the medicines or in terms of effect. Otherwise, you know, whatever you talk, we will come to the conclusions, because US will have all the steps where we can get it. So really, we should break that mindset, whoever it is, no, it can be hacked. You know, that kind of, thought we have to bring in. That's a zero trust architectures we have to bring into your organizations. That's what I have touched upon, you know, all the major areas in terms of the Facebook, Microsoft, Marriott, and Twitter. So whoever it is, it's like all bigger giant, but still you are hackable. Still you will have some vulnerability because it's you are playing with the people. You are playing with the multiple vendors, right? If you have any one, connect from there, I can get into your complete database from there, we can, take it forward. That's the overall, stuff I have, given. In fact, what are the link we are using Zoom? Close to 5 lakh account username and, the credential got published in the, document. Because the earlier stages, if you want to log in, it won't ask for password. It won't allow admin to, admit you. It won't allow admin to promote you as a, presenter. They will have all the control as well as from there, they were able to penetrate and then get this complete 5 lakh of user database. It's a very bigger way, right? Because the entire conversation, 5 lakh account means 5 lakh people transaction I can see, I can hear, I can be part of your session. So it is a huge, right? Or I can host a session on behalf of you with your ID. That's a way on the, the bigger level it was happening coming. But of course, now they have streamlined. Now they put a lot of controls. So, things are moving in the, the positive directions. So that's why it's a huge stuff. This all related to the, in terms of, the applications, which may not be on the IoT. But IoT part definitely, we'll touch what are things, we have it. Anything else you wanted to have it here? You want anything? Of course, British Airways in 2018, like who are the flyer, high flyer, who's going to which countries, all the transactions it was taken from their database. And then I know that, right? Who is a privileged customer, who can target for my business, how we can, move ahead. That's on the bigger way where we have, taken on that. Yeah. Duff Smash, I forgot to tell you, Duff Smash is a the branded as well as all the fun factors it was coming. But finally, it has reached to the Duff Smash to the all the big shots, right? All the actor and actors, politicians, they started to use the Duff Smash. Like instead of someone else, their voice it comes, but our video will, mix with that so that you can make fun of those transactions. So the Duff Smash, it's a very interesting one. Duff Smash is close to 162 million record it got leaked out. Their username password. Let us take a Shah Rukh Khan account, right? From Shah Rukh Khan account, I can log in and then show that what are the, I can put some of the pictures, right? Which is very not relevant or which is absolutely irrelevant stuff actually. So those pictures, I can put it on top of, on behalf of maybe Shah Rukh Khan or on behalf of maybe Narendra Modi or whoever it is, right? But a counterpart, they will think how Shah Rukh Khan is posting such a post or such a, the pictures over there. That's why it is on the very bigger way, it's went and hit on the way actually. Great. So now I believe 40 minutes, 1 hour, 20 minutes, we have it, 25 minutes, sorry. So we touched upon this more, agenda towards like what we are going to talk and then what are the key area we want to, touch on that. Of course, we'll just one or two slides, we'll touch on IoT so that we'll be in sync. We all will be in the same page. what the dimensions, you know, we have it, right? And then we'll touch on IoT benefits, and then what are the components, key components we have, how the architectures, and then doing architectures, of course, I'm not going to deep dive on architectures, because 2 hours, really, I want to give an essence of IoT plus the cybersecurity, so that you can have a view, like what are the possibility of attack which may can happen. Then cybersecurity challenges, so we have n number of challenges. But now, evergreen domain in upcoming world is cybersecurity. There is no second thought. Of course, AI, ML play major and significant role. But if you can ML take a lot of data, right? To train, it takes a lot of data. So really, we need to protect those data, right? So which of the field you touch? So now all the security, let's take Alexa speaker at home, right? Alexa speaker, you kept mic on your bedroom or your hall. So whenever you have a conversations, whatever the conversations you're doing, Alexa will hear. And then whenever they want to take it up, they can control, right? It may not be a Google itself, but it's maybe somebody else can hack your Alexa component and then hack and view that actually. So that's it. I'll give you some more use cases so that you understand the perspective. I have small camera hacking kind of stuff actually. If it is a 1 day, 2 day session, really we can do a lot of stuff. But however, we'll cover all the high level. Always from IoTs, where people have two dimensions or two perceptions. I'll tell you a small story. There is a parent in the beautiful village. The parents have two sons. So moreover, the 1 year difference of son. The younger son got into the very big way actually, where he started to study and he's a topper in schools, colleges, and then he started his own business. Business also is, he's doing wonderful work from end to end. And he started a revenue off in terms of $1 billion. That's the other son, right? The elder son. And he got into the, it's like more the drunken kind of stuff. He's not doing anything. He's drunken. He was at a hometown. He couldn't do any, much progress and all the things. So the media person really, they're surprised. It's like a same village. It's a two sons. The age also close to 1 year, 1 year difference. And it's the same parents, same school they studied. And then what did make him in as a billionaire? And then what did make other guy as another drunk and, where he spoiled his entire life, right? So that's the reason behind us. So the interview of the first person told, in terms of the younger one who was a billionaire, yes, my dad was complete drunken and he never used to go for work. He will be at home and then always my mom used to take care of the entire family. And that's the way I have seen really, I don't want to be, us like our dad. Somebody, I think, doing annotations. Maybe you can stop annotations. Yeah, this is what it happened, right? If you don't control the annotations, they can start writing something like that. Lakshmi, I think you can stop annotations, on the other way. I believe all the trusted people on the sessions. Lakshmi, can you hear me? Lakshmi, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Sir, we can stop the annotation, sir. We can go to more disable participant annotation. More button to disable participant annotation. Then annotation, okay, yeah, clear, yeah. Annotation. These two we do know, sir. They will not be allowed to do this kind of drawing.
Yeah, yeah. Anyway, I have done it.
Thanks, sir.
I have done it. Yeah,
no problem. Yes, going well, sir. You can proceed, sir.
Amazing. Oh, sorry, I left the story. This is how younger one told, my dad is that stage, really, I don't want to put myself into that kind of situation. So, and then as well as my mom was working at home, she's taking care of entire family, at the same time she was earning. So I don't want to give that kind of situations to any of other girl who's going to get married myself. So it's a learning, yes, he has taken in the, you know, the positive way, and then he has went ahead and created such a bigger portfolio business and become a billionaire. And the other person's got interviewed. He was telling, my dad was drinking, what else I can do? You know, that's what he has given to me. You know, he's not taught me anything, you know, the great stuff. He is not given the guidance. He has not shown the path to me, right? So ultimately, it's the same parent, same environment. How we take, how we move ahead it's very important, right? So that's the way, if you take the IoT also, always we should have multiple views, multiple, the dimensions. So one side, always people will look on the, in terms of what are the application it's going to give. But from cybersecurity standpoint, before reaching this application, I'll see how the informations can be misused, how the informations can be, altered, those way actually. From the story, it has a very clear perceptions, like how you have a perception, how you want to take it up, it's very important. So that play everywhere, but however, from the IoT standpoint, just I'm putting, a little bit, the focus so that we can have multiple dimensions, whatever, whenever, the product comes where we do threat modeling. Really, this will fit or this will have any other flaw or something like that, right? That's the way it's just like a small assessment. At home also, we may see, right? The kids, the way we play, we may see that definitely they're going to fall. That's your predictions. You would have seen it. After a few seconds, you can see that, right? The kids would have fallen. Because that's your predictions, you have a dimension. But the kids have focused only on to play, on the water or whatever it is. But you have a different dimensions. Safety of kids, right? The same way, if you take a cybersecurity, always you should have a multiple dimensions, not only on the functionality, not only on the focus area. Really, we have to focus on the overall this areas. Great. This picture will give you the lot of stuff actually from end to end. What are the things where we can take it up? You can have just a rough look, or maybe any of the one wanted to give explanations, just you can unmute any of one. You can just tell me like what it is, so that we can make a little bit more interactive. Any of one.
Yeah, I have unmuted participants. You can communicate through audio also. Because of IoT and automation, they have lost job.
Yeah, that's true. But on top of that, what else we can have a look actually? No, really, this it's like a post-lunch, right? In my view, always sure. Post-lunch, I'll extract all the input from audience, right? I want to make them as, because they have all the content. Only thing is we have to put it on the right manner. I think one of the gentlemen, wanted to express. Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
To take the top view, previously we used to take it using the helicopter or something like that. Nowadays, drone has overridden it.
Amazing. Yeah, thank you so much, sir. Shall I have your name and...
Myself, Ramchandra Rao from RGMCET Nandyal, sir.
Amazing. Yeah, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for the input. Amazing input. It's IoT is one case. It's absolutely right. But we are losing jobs earlier. If you see, we need a separate helicopter, separate person, separate camera. You think about, right? So to manufacturing of the camera, the labor force, and then helicopter, it's all three component. It's completely gone. We lost, those manufacturers. Leave about this helicopter. The helicopter manufacturing will have a lot of components, right? Camera will have a lot of components. The human will have a lot of, other enforcing agency and all the things. So that's why it has a lot of, stuff. Really, we are going to lose it. But as the end users, we are going to gain it. You are going to use, in terms of your drones. That, right? The UPS and then the entire UK, Amazon, they are doing the coordinations how we can deliver parcel through, the drones. It may not require the human people. It's already they have delivered, but it has a lot of challenges, right? I can fix a bomb. There is a chief minister even, you know, 5 kilometer before, 5 kilometer ahead, I can, you know, operate and then I can send the drones and then drop the bomb, right? Absolutely possible. Think about it. You are driving somewhere, you know, it's handy. If I want to attack you, it's very simple for me, right? Wherever you are traveling towards the outside world, I want to attack only one, you know, yourself. Wherever you are having coffee, wherever you are in tea, where you parked your car, I can drop the bomb through, you know, the drones. Just, you know, from the top, I can drop it. So that's the way, you know, customer standpoint, we have a lot of positive side, negative side, but at the same time, the inventions, it's really losing jobs. But really, we have to update ourselves to take it to be how we can generate the, you know, the drones, and then as well as how we can adapt the things. It's a very important stuff. So that's the way the last 10 years, if you see, there's a lot of changes, so, you know, which is happening across industry, across the world, and really, you all, you know, I'm not sure what's the age range you have it. If you are a little bit close to 40, you are might be well versed with the Nokia. The Nokia, they not put a lot of investments on in terms of innovations. The Kodak camera, they have not put a lot of investments on the, you know, research and then adapting new technology, right? The Kodak is the one. Wherever you see that, the earlier stages, we have a film roll, right? We have a 30 film roll. They are the only giant, Konica and Kodak. If you're a little bit old, you might be knowing that actually. Where we have a film camera, each and every photo we take very accurately because each and everything is cost, right? Now, if you see this mobile, we take, you know, the, you know, 100 snap on the same, you know, with the, you know, 5 degree, 10 degree difference. The innovations are really going, you know, ahead. The same way our update also, it's very much just required. The Nokia, if you see that, they're out of business. If you see this 15 years back, Nokia is the only one, they were ruling this entire, you know, the world. Specifically India, who are, you know, upcoming. Because it's affordable, right? 20,000, 30,000, just where we can have entire stuff, where we can create, where we can get the mobile, we can talk to each other. That's the way, it's a bigger way. So it's not only losing jobs, really, we wanted to move ahead from end to end in terms of innovation. So let's keep tap on the innovations. Now, what's happening on the, you know, the industry side? Of course, in the research is very important, but the research to the industry, a little bit there is a gap still. We need to, you know, the bridges. I think that is intention. This you know, FDP and then all of the program which is happening across the world. The next important stuff. See, this is just we are first. I want to create impact, and then we'll go a little bit on architectures and all the steps and all. Right? There's a product called Jeep, right? The company name itself, it's Jeep actually. Yeah, Nidhi, maybe I can hold it. Maybe if you have any quick answer, I can give it to you. Yeah, Nidhi, go ahead. That's a participant called Nidhi. Raise a hand. Okay, if you don't have any questions.
Sir, Nidhi Sinha would like to speak to you, I guess. So I have unmuted. She can unmute and communicate. Sure.
Hello, sure. Sir. Very good afternoon. I was so glad to hear that even you are pursuing PhD in security. And as even I am doing, sir, my topic is context-aware security in IoT. And,
amazing.
The thing I want to know about your topic as well. And the thing what exactly I want to ask from you is, like, as we are talking about security, sir, authentication, so many things, mean so many applications are there which are really working good nowadays in a mature manner.
Yeah.
For authorization, yet so many things has to be done in to make technology mature. I think authorization is a place where I am finding out that so lot many things has to be done.
Absolutely. I'm listening.
Yeah, actually, I want to know what exactly you think about the aspect of authorization while any IoT device are going to, like, communicate with each other dynamically.
Yeah.
That is my fun question one. And what kind of protocols, if you have, you can enlighten me on that, as well as about the protocols, like if you go for a dynamic authorization, what scenarios we should take care while we should take care when we should go for not we when any device should communicate with each other, and about protocols also, if you have any idea.
So yeah, that's great. You know, of course, you know, nowadays wherever we are facing this issue, so this is the key challenges where we are facing. But however, you know, to avoid this flow, I'll give up two very high level stuff actually. So in terms of authentications, authorization is the, you know, key stuff which is you know, happening from, you know, the end to end. Now, more of the industry standpoint, what we are you know, working out and deploying is FIDO2, phosphorless authentications. If you see this, most of the attack, what's happening now is it's like more of the phishing or fierce phishing. Like, let us take the people are talking about two-factor authentications, like you know, you have a OTP. You have a first, you know, your login, username, and then passwords, and then you have given your OTP. Now, this OTP can be hacked, right? If you do the wishing, I can get the OTP. That's what, there's a major fraud.
Too much of disturbance. I didn't hear what last.
Can you hear me?
What is, Sinha, what is the problem? What you could pay face?
Hello?
Come on, repeat again. Yeah, could you repeat again? We couldn't hear your voice. It is stable. Please check at your end. Both host okay. End and presenter end, it's going stable. Yes, sir. Let's proceed, sir.
Okay, amazing. So that's like a FIDO2. Anyway, we'll talk in detail also. That is a pure passwordless authentication. From end to end, it may not require any passwords. But it will you know, do the authentications from end to end. You know, we can you know, take it forward. So that's a new mechanism which is coming to the beginning, and then from there you know, we can you know, take it forward actually.
No sir, then what about sir, yeah, what do you think about the trust then, if we device two devices are going to be talking to be each other, then if there is no password or such kind of no scenarios, then what about the trust, sir? Like, even
so
you have to take care
is,
of
a... Yeah, no, it's a two-way, right? If you take a phishing, what happening is your username password. Let us take your username password. I'm sending, if I have your username password of your organizations, where I can transfer maybe from your account, or maybe I can transfer the things from you know, your bank, or maybe your you know, organizations, whatever you call it is. Ultimately, I need a credential. If I get your username password, I can do a lot of stuff. That's what it is, a major attack which is happening. To prevent those stuff, what's happening is, you know, nowadays it's all the FIDO2 mechanisms, passwordless authentications. Absolutely, we have to secure on the device, either of one, right? As you know that what you have, what you are, what you know, right? What you know is the major one, it's exploited. So now FIDO2, it's really touching on what you have it, right? It's maybe the authentications. It's like on, you know, the public, you know, the cryptography, where from end to end, it does the handshake. At the same time, it will ensure that what are the authentications happening, where you have a device, you know, in your hand. That will give a lot of stuff. In terms of SSO also, it's came into the, you know, those pictures. It's a completely, it's going, and then it's moving on the, you know, the right directions. In fact, AWS and then Azure also started to deploy, you know, FIDO2, of authentications based mechanisms. Because passwords, no, it's absolutely, I can give it to you, right? If I have a friend, I can give it to you and then you can log in. Now it's a unique, right? It takes your geolocations. It takes, you know, your, the way pattern you open the key, it will take you. It has some many, if you don't do, it will have, you know, a lot of ideas. Yesterday you were in the different location, today you were in different locations, but it will ensure that you are in the right locations from where you are accessing the applications. You got it, right? So that's why we have the FIDO2. FIDO2 itself, we have a geo-based and then trust-based and then your behavior pattern-based. So we have a lot of mechanisms on the live, specifically on the cloud systems where we have started to, you know, the deploy, specifically on the AWS, Amazon, they are going ahead and then ahead actually. Of course, we'll have, you know, the detailed discussion. I love to, you know, take it forward. I can give a lot of suggestions, input.
Sir, there is a question from Gajendra. In IoT, any object has IP address, and to know IP address, anybody can attack on it. So how we can say that we are secure when we use IoT products? In the chat box, question is there.
Okay, great. So maybe this one, I have a couple of slides. Definitely, it's a great question. So definitely, we should be able to answer. Lakshmi, just you take this question as the parking area, and then definitely we will address this. We'll have answers, but let's flow with Nidhi. No. I believe partially I had answered to you. Definitely, we'll have detailed discussions, maybe about your research as well as where and all. If anywhere I can help you, or maybe I can learn from you, I'm happy to connect. We'll do that. Okay. Amazing thing. This is a control on Jeep, right? That's the two things I have deployed. One is Jeep left side, you can see, and then another one is a skateboard. If you take a European countries or maybe US, specifically in the European countries, most of the guys, they will have skateboard because they have a dedicated track for the skateboard. Even cycles, even the walkers, they will not get into the skateboard because they are so health conscious. Specifically in Australia, if you see this, they have a lot of dedicated track only for the skateboard as well as the cycles. So now they are getting into a lot of the internet device. It gives a traffic map route, and then it gives a lot of other integrations. So now we can hack this scatting board itself, where you are going in the maybe 20 kilometer speed. I can stop you, or I can skid you, or I can get into somewhere else, or I can misguide you. Right? It's a small skating board, but I can do a lot of steps into the the overall stuff. So that's a way where we are connecting a lot of applications layer as well as layer 2, layer 3 also, which needs a lot of protections. But the next important stuff is this is on the Jeep, right? Nowadays, if you see most of the car, we call it as internet enabled cars. It's like we have IoT enabled stuff, like all the internet car, right? Maybe you can operate from outside. You can switch on, you can switch off, you can on this audio, video, wiper, whatever it is, right? It sends and then it will activate and all the steps and all. So this testing, where without knowing this person, that's a guy called Jack. He has got into the car and the car is locked and he started to drive with enjoying mode actually. The music system is suddenly on, with a full sound, where he couldn't bear this complete noise. That level complete system. Once the music system is on with the full speed, you try to focus on this volume control and all the steps at all. The parallelly, the AC level, it's went down minus on the freezing mode actually. So mentally, they started to test actually if the system got hacked, how the people mindset and then what are the actions they are doing that over there actually. The first one is the volume it went ahead. He's completely depressed. He is trying to reduce the volume. The AC level, it's went to the minus. It's not affordable to him. This entire backbone got freezed. When he's trying to manage the the AC, the wiper got on with the complete crease, whatever it is there in the engine. It started to populate and wipe this entire glass. Think about that. He's not switched on. He's not switched off the car. It's a very simple music systems. Always the people will focus on the engines, right? The people will focus on the brakes, shoes, all X, Y, Z, all the steps. But things are, it's different. They are touching on just simple music system. They are touching on the AC. They're touching on the wiper. Wiper is the least privileged one, right? The people not much focused in terms of the wiper, but the wiper is the one give a lot of visions to you on the road. So maybe you are in the 100 kilometer speed, the wiper is one swipe with the block, then you are gone, right? So that's the way the controls, all the things, it's coming to the pictures from end to end. So we need a lot of attentions. We need a lot of, the enforcements to, take it forward. So that's the way where we are focusing. If you take, car manufacturing, of course the industry is down now, but if you see this, we have lot of advancements, a lot of focus, not only in terms of mechanic, electronic, and then hackers also getting to the for manufacturing and then trying to address more of them. Amazing. So it's not only in core, right? Just we put it different area. Now we put a Rafale, right? A Rafale from France, you know that, right? It's a multi-crore, I think close to 54,000 crores where we bought the Rafale jet. That is a pure fighting jet, right? That's a pure electronic stuff where it targets a multiple target at the same time and then it keep attacking over there. So similarly, rifle also, right? A rifle, earlier we see that the focus is bigger challenges, right? Really now the people have to hold and then see the focus, electronically focus the entire stuff and then you can trigger it. This also can be hacked. Where you have a, there's a war, it's happening, maybe you are Indian guys, other people also, it's roaming on the same area. Where I can hack this entire gun and I can change the target. While seeing, it looks like, the other part, what you are seeing. But while triggering, it goes to and hit, other part who is next to that. Think about it, right? It's a human life, right? It's once triggered, then it's gone actually. So that's why your rifle also can be hacked from end to end because it has a lot of integrations with your hardware as well as in the software area. Because people are still, we are talking about the website, right? E-commerce website and other area. Still, we are not touched on the IoT area. But IoT is the one it's going to rule, from end to end, which is going to yield the results as well as it's going to give up, comfort zone. This is, I have touched at home, right? So if you see your site, you may, a couple of people, you may have Alexa speakers and then what are the things you have done it, you can, take it forward from the Alexa standpoint. I think it's a old one. So this, if it is possible, just you can take out Lakshmi, this annotation, this line, whatever you have it parallel, you can take out. Sometimes it may disturb the numbers and all the things and all.
Sir, you please go to annotate button, sir. And in that annotate, clear one will come. Even I'm taking screenshots. Yeah, clear. Clear all, clear, then clear all drawings will come. Delete button. Yeah, now if you share and disable participants drawing, that would be great, sir.
Perfect. I believe it's done, right?
Yes, sir. After sharing, go to more button, sir. Disable participants annotation. That if you put, nothing can be done, sir.
I have disabled it. Already I have disabled it.
Ah, that's it, sir.
Perfect. Amazing. I was talking about, we have a list time, I believe, but I have more slides. Let's see on this. Because its content is keep coming. I have touched on your DTH, right? If you see this IoT, it's not separate, right? It's IoT is your mobile. Your mobile is connected to the entire world, right? Whatever you want to do the operations, you can do that. In terms of, I can track your location since and all the way, right? So your mobile have a camera. How many people will have a camera cover? It may not be right. Always you keep your mobile on your pockets. That means you are created your third eye, right? Third eye to your entire world. So you can, that's what always we suggest, right? If you want talking any secret stuff, you should cover the camera by notes or paper or whatever it is, the respective stuff. Even in fact, I'm talking to multiple, the manufacturer, really we should bring a physical camera cover actually. Because now really we are not sure, right? All the applications will have access to your camera, whatever you have it. Anytime they can switch on, like wherever you are it, they can monitor over there actually. It's very simple, right? If you take applications, how do you know that? As an end users, we cannot be expert all the time. Really, we don't know like what are the things monitored by whom, by when, what, as well as your home. That's what, couple of people, actually I had one more separate session, how do we control your, the video camera? And what are the things which needs to be taken care of from things? What are the controls where we can take control of your laptops? laptops at bedroom, laptops at restroom, in all the places we open the it's a laptop or the mobile, we do a lot of stuff. But really, we are not sure who are all monitoring you. It is a very, we need a lot of protections on your camera because you brought third eye to, your home. Anyway, to come in the track, just I have taken your DTH. Every house in India, we have a DTH, direct to home, where you can watch the channel, where you have your own dish, own box, you can watch what are the things you want to have it. I can see what are the channels you are watching that. Tata Sky, whatever it is, of course they have patched all the stuff, but however it is the earlier one, the Tata Sky account has been hacked. Once you get into your account, I can see all your channel subscriptions, what are the things you have done, as well as now we have recent mechanisms, you can record your, the videos, what are the channel you wanted. So I can record your videos, and then through this, Tata Sky or whatever things which is connected to the internet, I can take control of your TV camera. Most of the TVs are internet connected, right? So I can access your TV camera. I can see that because the TV always, you keep it in center of hall, right? So you have kept your eye on the center of your hall. I can watch whatever you want. In fact, I don't want disclose, but however, on the to give a magnificence of what are the impact it was happened, where really just I wanted to give that. Through the one of the guy mobile where they have taken the control, he was in Dubai. It's not through Tata Sky, it's something else. Just I'm giving the scenarios. They have taken the control of their the mobile. Once he hacked his mobile, and then his TV is paired through the internet actually. So once we connected through this mobile, where we were the people able to hack this TV through the TV, where they were able to see this entire bedroom. They have recorded and then put it on the dark web, and then after that one it came to the picture of like who's the person and then how it is taken. Think about it. So things are going, we are living with the multiple organs, right? It's not only our body, but always with all electronic gadgets, what we have it, it has a lot of mechanisms to monitor, track things at home, things that are your office, and then whatever you do, from end to end. That's why we need a lot of, protections, not only at the organization's level, really at end user level also. So that's what we are insisting, a lot of stuff from the end user standpoint, really we have to teach your students and then from yourself, as well as your peers, what are the countermeasures which needs to be, taken care of. Great, let's get to the track. So the DTH where the people are able to get into the hacking of this stuff, and then where they can record the sessions, whatever they wanted to have it. So that's the way it is a very bigger level, which was happening across the world. Then the people are getting into the countermeasures. The countermeasures, what are the things which I'll tell you in the upcoming slides. So now ultimately the connected is now all the devices are connected. You know that, right? Your brush have the Bluetooth. Your brush, toothbrush will have internet connected. It will tell you how your digestion power, what you had yesterday, that the food is, it's really digestive for you or not, based on your health conditions. So because with the brush, it will have a sensors and then it will detect you how your brushing sense, how your eating habit, what you have to change, what should not have it, what should have it at what time, so that your digesting power will control your body. You call it, right? A small brush, but it will take you into the next level. So that's a level of, the controls, which is really going from, the end to end. So that's when we need a lot of protection. So, how we are going to protect it. Before getting to the car, maybe since I was talking about DTH, how secure your Wi-Fi router at home? How secure your mobile? You have done the hotspotting, right? Now, most of the people that work from home, you would have enabled the hotspot, right? From the mobile itself. Or if you have a broadband, you may have a Wi-Fi routers. It will have SSID. Just during call, maybe post call, you take your router and see the bottom. You can see your username is admin, password is admin123. it's a very scary in our apartment where we have 1,000+ of, you know, houses. It's all, you know, CIO, CTO, it's like the leadership community. But really during the early sessions where I was able to walk and hack up, you know, multiple leadership home, you know, the routers and switches where we were able to land up on their, you know, laptops. So really just, I not put it as a screenshot, but how about just please ensure that just you are, you know, taking care of the entire, you know, the routers also needs to be taken care of. Because admin, let us say you have Airtel. Everybody knows that the username is admin123. So anyone can record. Let us take a Sugi Kai who's coming to, you know, deliver something, or any delivery boy coming to your house. He can access your, you know, internet. We used to call it as a war dive actually. So that's a way, you know, it's on the bigger way, you know, what are the things which needs to be taken care from end to end. That is a really bigger session in terms of Wi-Fi. Even I had done the notifications to certain as India level, really we have to, you know, take care of, need a lot of awareness, right? Because earlier we are not sure what time we are in office, what time we are at home, but now everybody's at, you know, home and then consistently where we can hack it actually. So let us ensure that, you know, that level of, you know, the controls, however we can take it forward, what are the other stuff which needs to be, you know, taken care of. Amazing. So this is just a car with a nameplate. Maybe any of one wanted to have a comment, give a comment, what do you feel by seeing this, you know, the car? What it is, what it can be getting in, or what you looks like as a layman, what do you see by seeing this? Anyone can want to comment it, you know, you can comment it. Whatever it is, there's no right and right or wrong answer. You know that, right? Always strongly believe. Maybe from your thought, that's what I touched upon the perception. Your perceptions might be different. That's what we have this many, you know, taste of food, right? This many variety of dresses, this many variety of cars. Because everybody perception, everybody taste is, you know, different. Even the same tongue only, right? So tongue size remains same, but the taste bud is different, right? So that's what, you know, I wanted to hear your input, what you think on this. Lakshmi, maybe we can unmute whoever want to raise it. Maybe you can raise a hand and maybe Lakshmi can unmute and can
help. Sure.
Anybody would like to?
Open choice given, anyone can unmute and can give your voice.
Amazing, that's great. Anyone else wanted to have it? Just whatever you feel, whatever you think, you can give that. That's not a, you know, the problem at all. Just car, or maybe whatever you think, actually. Anyone else wanted to give thought? Just maybe I'll take a few seconds. If it is not, then I can open that. Really, just I want to hear from you, right? Whatever you feel. At least I'll have some acknowledgement you are in front of laptop or in front of, you know, the display.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Sir, actually, I didn't get your question, sir, because your voice is a little bit slow, sir. That's why.
No problem at all. Just I wanted to know what you think, what you feel by seeing this car. Just I have
this is a sensored equipped card, or we can say the smart car.
Okay, it's a smart car. Okay, fine.
Sensor equipped card.
Okay, sensor equipped car. Okay.
Yes. And the industry producing the smart card. So this is a sensor equipped card with a good facilities, I think.
Okay, what else you feel? Anybody else raising hand apart from this? Of course, it's maybe the, you know, smart car or something like that. That's looks good, okay. But from outside, how you come to know? Maybe you think anything else you felt it's like a smart car or something? If you raise a hand, we'll get notifications, right? I don't need to go through that internet.
Sir, is it RFID band?
Hello, sir.
Yeah. It's RFID band.
Yes, the nameplate is quite lengthy, and I think so many things are written on that.
Amazing. I like your views actually. Maybe RFID band looks like so many things written on the, you know, the nameplate. That's great actually. I didn't get your good name, madam. Please.
Nidhi Sanha, sir.
Nidhi Allen. Okay. Yeah. You're right, Nidhi. Yeah. Some extent. Okay. Fine. Any other perception? Anything else?
Sir, Graphlon, sir. I'm audible, sir.
Very clear, madam. Please go ahead. Just you can start with your name.
This is Mr. Sultana, sir, from MGIT. Sir, can you suggest any research-oriented IoT, sir? IoT problems? Research-oriented IoT problems, sir?
Yeah, we can talk. We can talk in the upcoming stuff, actually. Definitely, okay. We'll touch upon those areas also.
Okay, sir. Please, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Great. That's great, actually. So this is it's a very simple stuff, right? It can be used for research also, but however, it's a small problem. See, this is
one more thing I saw in this. Actually, at the left side, there is some blue color. I think some sensor or maybe camera is there in that.
Okay, amazing.
I exactly don't know because that picture is not that much clear. But just beneath the drop, where drop has written, there is something.
Absolutely. That's great, actually. That's absolutely great, actually. Thank you so much for your observation. This is what it does is, so this is a robbers, in US, these guys are, it's a pure robbery. Like wherever they are going to take a robbery of the bank, they use this car. As well as they take a route of wherever, let us take the camera, this camera, if it captures this image, it will drop the entire database. It will delete the entire database from the systems. So they know the route, they know the bank. Let us take, they have 10 banks. They would have done the complete analysis, like which are the banks they are using the same variety of camera. What are the vulnerability it has? Similarly, overall on the road also, wherever we have this database, backend also we have the same kind of table. So wherever this CCTV camera capture this, this image, it will go and drop this database. It will delete this entire database, whatever, because that's a default table, they have it. Think about, right? It's a very simple table. The people not manually going to the systems and organizations, and then they are dropping this entire database, they are deleting the entire database as and when the hacking is done or before getting into the robbery areas. It's a very smart. So what they have done is analysis is wherever there is a robbery, it's happened, they have found CCTV images got deleted. It was absolutely the different the view, right? I mean, how it got deleted and all the things. So that's what this is a small control. So but however, where it's a small command, just a few words of command, it can activate, it can deactivate this entire the database actually. Great. So that's the purpose of things, but really we have to focus on not only in the IoT, really the software level also, which needs to be taken care. So yeah, IoT and this application is well integrated, right? Your application is whatever it is capturing, but it is activating, dropping somewhere else, whatever it's supposed to be. Amazing. The next interesting stuff is the Bluetooth, right? Just moreover, I touched upon wherever we have the concepts of the Bluetooth, those things and all where we have given actually. So this is a Bluetooth where I can hack your Bluetooth and then I can get into your systems. With the help of a Bluetooth, that, right? You can have a tracking of overall, your system mobile actually, from end to end actually, right? So once you get into the Bluetooth, it's nothing, right? The people will just ignore it. The Bluetooth may not be get it done through anything else actually. So that's the way just where we have to, we have taken from end to end, and where the Bluetooth can be hacked, and then once the Bluetooth is hacked, where I can clone the entire system. So that's what just I have given as a chain of bluebone attack. It's like in a few seconds, if I attack one Bluetooth, and then I can attack, what are the Bluetooth systems which is, erasing the nearby areas. So that's, the bigger areas where we have touched it on that. Great. This is a very, we have close to...
Hello, sir. Sir, just a minute. Actually, I got the instance, this one. As we are talking about Bluetooth in the different devices, is it?
Yeah.
So I got a point that, whenever we try to connect with someone, so many lists we will get. And I think that this list which we are getting, like though they are telling that they are secured or we have to connect and then, but the hacker can hack anything. Na, where, so it might, one more aspect is there that we can, without permission of the person who is actually having a Bluetooth facility, it should not be visible to anybody, I feel.
Absolutely.
Think about that?
No, absolutely. Your point is valid. It should be visible. But really, I'm thinking...
Visibility?
Visibility only to the known people, as well as the visibility or accepting the traffic only to the known device. How many of us really...
We are exposed to all. We don't know that we are exposed to all. If someone wants to see whether we are in the list, we will, as we are nearby, like proximity will be there, definitely it's going to be catch out that there is one some device having Bluetooth. Okay. And it starts, initial communication starts, sir, that this is the device, this is the name. Hi, I am this, I am that. So I feel that I think this is the most insecure thing which I found. Now instantly I got it. When I was hearing your this one session, sir.
Amazing. Yeah, thank you so much for input. Really, that's true, actually. Really, we should have it as visible only to the known device. And each should have, the password enabled. If you want to accept, if you want to send a file, receive a file, if you want to pair any device, really, it should prompt for the password. If you don't have that option, so like anyone can, get into the things. So it's a very simple technology, right? As rightly you told, if you do the yoga, if you do the exercise, or if you have a food at very regular timing, if you sleep at regular timings, then you are absolutely healthy, right? If you don't take much pressure, you are healthy. So we know all three factors, right? In terms of food, timing, health, and then exercise, yoga. That's the four things. If you do, you are healthy. The same way, security also, there are parameters. There are, the inputs where the people have given, like if you do the X, Y, Z, you are healthy. But how many of us, we do that? That's what it is, the bigger questions. So one got exploited, then we can connect to the, all the sequence of systems, which is, connected from, the end to end. So that's the way where overall, the Bluetooth got it hacked. And then, that, right? It may not require much technologies. Maybe I can ask some of my friend saying that, just give me 1 minute, I'll take a call and then I can give it to you. Just if maybe you can dial a number, while dialing number, you can enable the Bluetooth also. Then chat is over. With the Bluetooth, I can clone the entire mobile also. With the hotspot, I can clone the entire mobile also. It's absolutely possible. Great. Yeah. Thank you so much. Great. This is, I think the session goes long. Now only just moreover, I wanted to just, I have given all the impact. What are the impact really industry level it's happening? Where I have handled and then where the people have, handled, what are the challenges where we are going to connect it. So that's the way this IoT system is. It's not anything specific, special or, separate. It's like whatever we handle at our hand, whatever you have it in the your home, that's what it is going to talk. Your washing machine, your TV, your fridge, your heater, your AC, everything it's going to talk each other and then going to, well connected. And then in terms of research, where we can do a lot of stuff in the IoT area. In fact, my domain also in terms of I'm touching the blockchain, IoT plus cyber security. This is a, the major three area where I'm touching. It's a huge, the market. In terms of multi-million dollars of business, it's waiting over there actually. But only thing is just we have to strike on which domain and then which sectors where you are taking, where they need a more demand, where you want to take it up. Of course, why we are getting to this IoT? you know, everybody knows it's a time management, right? It automates all the stuffs. You know, if you want to, let us take, you are leaving from, you know, different city and you're going home. Once you're going home, just you want to take a bath, a very warm and a hot bath. Just maybe once you leave the car, you can set a timer, switch on, like, you know, before reaching my home, 15 minutes, switch on my heater. So it tracks your car, you know, speed, it tracks your car movement, and then see that how much kilometer you have a speed and how much distance you have to cover, and then how much time will take, and then it will switch on your heater. So similarly, we have a lot of applications, right? In terms of that, it has a time management, it has automation, it has the luxuries. But the only thing is where we need a lot of cautious effort to protect the data from, you know, the implement. So this is a, you know, bare minimum components in terms of, you know, from end to end. Each component where we can zoom and then deep dive, like what are the possibilities of attack, where we can, you know, have it, and then how we can, you know, take it forward. That's maybe the very bare, you know, it's the electronics, right? The electronics, earlier, if you see, the people will have a PLC kind of stuff in terms of automations and all the things and all. So, completely electronics will not have a, you know, the layer 3, layer 4. It has a layer 1, layer 2, right? In terms of the TCP, it may not have a much other things. So, where we can have a physical access to the electronic device. Then there is a communication protocol. From layer 2 to layer 3, this is how you're going to communicate, how you're going to talk. That time, you know, most of the organizations, they don't apply their, in terms of the encryptions and all the things that goes in the different way. The network interface between your, you know, hardware to the software, or maybe hardware to hardware, or maybe sensors to the hardware, those interface, how we are going to protect it. Then all the data, it's really on the centralized way. It's on the cloud security. And of course, finally, it will land upon your end users applications, or it's maybe the mobile. So each one will do the deep dive and how you're going to, what are the challenges it has it, how you're going to protect it with the, you know, service security mechanisms, whatever. In terms of architectures, from cyber security standpoint, always we focus from end to end, right? As I rightly told, from end device to end device, what are the things which needs to be, you know, the technical. So we'll have a sensor, really the sensors also which need a lot of protections. Sensors also really we have to, you know, touch upon how you are going to take care of, how you are going to, you know, protect it in, on the physical. And of course, IoT gateway, you know, how the gateway has been controlled in terms of physically as well as logically, as well as on the each layer, how you are going to, you know, protect it. And of course, the applications layer, of course, so most of the things now we are getting to that. Then of course, there's a separate layer called event processing layer. You know that, right? From end to end, how you are going to communicate, and then how you are going to take care of what are the actions it's coming, how it is moving towards the, you know, the meaningful realization. So that's you know, considers the event processing layer. So this is all four layers which need to be protected from cyber security standpoint, which need a lot of, you know, attentions. I have to stop on you know, the applications. In terms of where we have connected cars, as I rightly told, a lot of cars itself well connected, where we can control from end to end, in terms of your steering, pure, and in terms of your braking pads, like, you know, the entire things can be in the control. As well as, you know that, right? Nowadays, the insurance sectors really, they come out with based on your usage. Let us take, you have a you know, Benz car. I also have a Benz car, but I drive maybe a Benz car very rough way and then in the different way. But you drive the Benz cars in terms of very smooth and point to point, very limited kilometers. Same model, same year we bought it, but the way we handle it is different, right? So that's the way the insurance sectors, it's really, they are putting a lot of effort. This is also really, you know, the great research area. The people are putting a lot of effort over there. How you're going to make a premium. It's like, you know, the multi-billion dollars it's playing over there actually. So how you're going to protect it, how you're going to control, how you're going to take care of, you know, overall things also. It's going to be a very significant impact on the market. Home appliances, most of the things, home appliances, it's AC and all, it came long back. AC and your, you know, heaters and all things, and all, it came into the picture. Public services, it's a many stuffs really, you know, the coming to the, you know, the way from end to end actually. Great, great of yours. Anything important? I think Gajendra has some input. Definitely, yeah. We love to hear from Gajendra also. Amazing. Yeah, definitely. Just maybe I can, Lakshmi, we can unmute Gajendra, Mr. Gajendra. Just we can take a few minutes to hear.
Yeah, yeah. He has several questions so that better. Already the provision is given, sir. Any moment they can unmute themselves. Unless there is no amazing background noise, I'm giving that option. Any background disturbance comes only.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great.
Rajendra,
sir, please unmute yourself and ask your questions.
Thank you, ma'am. First of all, thank you. Thank you. Sir, my question is, can Alexa, a Google product, share our search information to the company or other?
Yeah, go ahead.
Hello?
Yeah, we are listening. Go ahead. You are very clear. Go ahead with your
question. Sir. So my question
the question is, Alexa will search our information, our history, our attitude, our personal things. So will it be a danger with Alexa product or Siri like communicative devices? That is what the question I guess.
Yes, sir. And yes, ma'am. And maybe in a previous, I think before 1 month, I heard that Google also hacked. That's why my question is, if we are using these types of product, then how we are safe? How we can say we are safe?
Yeah. No, amazing. The questions. I believe, I'm not sure, you would have watched it. Just a month back, there's a Congress meeting in US. The Congress is, they will have a set of questions. They will question all the leading firm where they have interviewed, Amazon CEO Jeff, Google Sundar Pichai, Amazon, Google, and then of course, Microsoft, our CEOs, as well as the fourth company, Apple. Yeah, this four company, they got interviewed the purely on the questions which is related to the tracking. I'm not sure if see this Sundar Pichai answer, where they were asking the question saying that, are you tracking my movement? Are you tracking what I'm doing? Are you tracking where and all I've entered?
Yes, I saw that.
Yeah.
Sundar
Pichai question is, if you say yes, I will monitor you.
Yes.
It's a very simple way he closed that answer. He said, if you have deceived, you have enabled, you want to track it, there is an option. But how many people have that option?
Okay, sir.
On all the things about. The same way, if you take this, what are the Alexa? Of course, sir, Alexa is have a pattern matching. Let us take, I'm not sure you are from which state, but however, let us take your popular heroine songs you want to listen on.
Actually, I'm from Gujarat, sir. Gujarati.
Gujarat. Maybe some Gujarati song, you wanted to hear in the evening, before going to bedtime, 9 o'clock. It will have a great history of, what are the songs you hear. It will ask you next day, would you like to play, so-and-so songs in the Gujarati?
Yes,
Alexa. Well, because that's what the product is designed. That want to give you experience, right?
Yes, sir.
They want to recognize your voice. They want to recognize what you like it, what you don't like it. Every day morning, you want to hear a news. Just you can tell them, just give me a top 10 news. It will give you that. The top 10
news
also based on your taste, it will give you. If you like on cybersecurity, it will give you about absolutely on the cybersecurity.
Yes.
If you about top trend, it will give you on the top trend. You got the logic, right? It's the entire business. If it's a Facebook, the Facebook running one side, that's what I told you. Perception is different. One side, we are talking about the Facebook, it is connecting the people. It is giving the lot of visibility of what people are doing, what people are, flourishing on their day-to-day activity. But it's not the way. The backend is business. The backend is there understanding your lifestyle, what you like, what you don't want to do that, right? That center thinks it's absolutely all the data is will be with them, but what kind of data you are going to share, what kind of things you're not going to take care of, because that with that only they can give your the comfort, right?
So that yes, thing sir, yes.
Is there. That's no second thought. Even if you ask Sundar Pichai itself, they will say yes. Yes, I have your data.
Means that they are just providing a facility and you can enable and disable. You have to enable or disable on our sides.
Absolutely. That's absolutely yes. Your control, right? See, anybody stopping you or me to do the yoga? Nobody's, right? If you do the yoga, you will be fit and fine. If you take regular water, it's like 5 liters or 10 liters of water. If you take, you are healthy. But who follow that? That's what it doesn't matter, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're right.
So do the yoga at 24 hours per day, you have it. You want to choose it, you choose it. If you want to be healthy, the same way. If you want to protect your data, you just go and disable whatever it's supposed to be, disabled.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Me, to answer your question is yes or no? Yes, they have all the data, whatever you have it. There's no second thought. Your entire mobile movement, whatever you touch in mobile, you may think like you may not have it. You may not, whatever you talk, you think like once you deleted the history, it will go off.
Yes, sir. I got it, sir. Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Amazing, Gajendra.
Thank you, sir.
Great. So, of course, supply chain, where we are going to make it, if you take maybe the blockchain and in terms of the IoT, you have, let us take a honey home, for you want to buy honey, right? And, always the honey will be expensive, but we wanted to know the honey is really the real honey. Or they have a sugar coated, or they have sugar melted. Once it's sold, right? Really, we are not sure. As well as every day, we can't test that the sugar content with what are the tests we do it. With the water and density and all the things. It's not possible, right? The life is going on the different way. So now we can track this entire stuff, like wherever you do the tracking of your goods, where the honeycomb is located, how many grams of honey we can get it, where it's tracked, where which industry is processed, where it is bottled, where is the label, where it is sold to the things. So the entire supply chain can be monitored through the overall IoT. The same way we are focusing on the cyber security side action. So now, of course, the retail and machine to machine, the applications also on the bigger way, it's going to hit in the bigger market. So this is not only on the electronics, right? It's always on the smart grid also. Smart grid really, it's on the bigger way. From end to end, where we have a multiple feed in terms of the power source, in terms of multiple other area where we are downloading overall the power, right? So if you want to bring down any country or any organizations, I can bring down the entire power also. So the powers are nowadays centralized based on where the load is more, where the load is less, where we can automate and then where we can take it forward. So that's a way, recently in Gurgaon, it's a major power grid, hacking was happened. It's in a very bigger way. So that's what the power grid protection also, it's a very, very important stuff. So IoT in terms of, what are the major issues and challenges we have is we have a lot of international standards because we have everywhere we can see that a lot of products it's being developed. If I think some sensors to detect a temperature or maybe weather, whatever it is, I can create it. But are we doing with the respect to international standard? Really, we are not sure, right? So that's why the lack of standards, because still it needs a lot of, it's a developing area, right? It's not completely settled down. So those areas just keep happening over there. Then in terms of passive attacks from end to end, absolutely whatever you have, because if you take IoT, sensor is one company, and then electronics device is one company, communication is one company, application is one company, and so overall integration is this other company. So multiple people, they are coming to the pictures. So really, we need a one standard to streamline the entire system. So if you take application website, the website is only one guy, right? Who developed the website, only those guys will be controlled. That's absolutely fine. But IoT, we need a lot of hardware and firmware and software applications, and then overall, the infrastructures. A lot of complexity is going to come over there. If you take a smart city, smart grid, or maybe supply chains and other things. Where the research really, we can take it to one of the problem statement, we can start focusing on that. And the research really, may not require to solve 1,000 problems. Take one problems, give the solutions, give this, what are the benefits we get it, ultimately we'll be, unique. This is upcoming way, the data is everything. That's no second thought. What are the data is generating from the end users, the end device, it's going to hit on the very bigger way. It's going to create a lot of, impact from the end to end. This image I was saying, right? Earlier, where we have Konica and Kodak film, and right side, if you see this, now it is in terms of multiple trillion data size where we are keeping in our mobile. Everybody is now, area if you see marriage or anything, so one cameraman will be there. Now everybody is, become a cameraman. And it's not, may not be one photo. It's the same time they can click multiple stuff. It's affordable, right? The device starts moving. And then earlier storage also, it's close to 1.4 Mbps. I'm not sure if any 120 years old in the industry, they might be knowing. Of course, my entire projects I was having in one floppy. This is a 1.44 MB, right? The entire 160 pages project I was having in 1.44 MB. Now I can't have one photo in 1.44 MB because each photo sizes, it goes in terms of multiple MB. So it's really drastically, it's going to hit on the market. This is a data facts. Really, I have given every 60 seconds overall creating what level of data. In terms of, if you see this WhatsApp, it's close to 41.6 million data it's being sent over the side. So similarly, all the social medias, it's like, earlier if you want to see, there is somewhere some riot it's happening, some news is happened, some accident is happened. Earlier, really, we have to wait for the next day newspaper. Or we have to wait for the news channel to deliver. Now, just 2-3 minutes, right? Who are on the road, he can take a clip and then he can upload on the social media, things will be populated. So that's the way the information is going on the bigger way from end to end, which is going to hit the market. So from cybersecurity standpoint, really always there are 1,000 attacks. The attacker has to be successful only once, right? Out of 1,000, if it is only once, if you penetrate it, absolutely fine. But the defender, we have to be successful all 1,000 out of 1,000 times. So that's why the cybersecurity play very significant, important role where we need a lot of determinations, where we should not give up anywhere, where we can take it forward. It's like a goalkeeper, right? The goal, the rest of the 11 people, whoever it is, they are going to get the ball. They can roam around the entire, court. But this goalkeeper always, you should get the ball. You should, put back, push back the ball. The way to get the goal. This I have given in the cybersecurity touch point, what are the things where we have it and then how we want to take it forward. And then this is whatever, just I have given very high level in terms of cybersecurity, why we have to, of course, feature is digital. In terms of your lights, tube lights, fan, because it's not going to work on only the industry side, right? It's going to touch on overall end users impact also. It's on the bigger way, it's going to hit and then it's going to connect this entire world so that the entire world when it's connecting, where we need a lot of security parameters which needs to be taken care of. The cybersecurity always, we have, the personality and curiosity, that's very important. And then where we need an interest, right? Like somebody suggest, and then somebody wanted to, give a guidance, those area we want to take it up. Really, we need a lot of interest and passion, and where we have, clear knowledge on the ground to take it. Of course, whatever the skill you have it, but without will, really, we can't move forward. So the skill and will combinations, I put a lot of effort and then do a lot of beautifications from into the end. Of course, ability can be taken care of if you have a will and skill where you can take it forward the way we want to have it. In terms of IoT, this is the key area really we want to touch is, as I told, where we have a multiple sectors, right? Where we have in terms of firmware, in terms of sensors, in terms of your physical layer, in terms of layer two, and then communications, and in terms of your hardware and integration of all the hardwares, and in terms of your applications, and then your front end. So all the things considered, as to where I have put it, it's close to 24 the major role which play very significant and then impactful role where we can take it forward from end to end. It's everything is very important, right? In terms of cryptography, it's very important because we want to take it off from layer two, how it is protected. Because if you take a layer four and the layer seven, we have a lot of mechanisms to the encryption. But how do we do it for the layer two? How do we do it for protect this in terms of the physical, right? That's also it's very important. So those areas also were really we have addressed. This is a key role really we want to have it. In terms of cybersecurity, we have in terms of entry, mid-level, and then senior management. Always senior management of the CISO role. That's like he's a king who sits on the top and do the supervision of the entire that we have given over there. And then we have a multiple roles, multiple designations where we can help in terms of the IoT to protect the overall the ecosystems. This is a very interesting slide. You can make a note. This will be applicable everywhere. This is Japanese concept. Of course, it's not only Japanese. It's like all the human being can get a play over there. Like always, we have to see what is your passion, what you love, what is your mission, and then what vocations, how the world needs from you, what the world's needs of internet connectivity, how you can connect the profession. The four things need to be connected, right? What you love, what you need, and then what you are paid for that in terms of the cost. And then really we have to find out where you are good at. It should not be like somebody's really suggesting a cybersecurity is good, so let's get into the things. We should not. Really, it should be your passion. It should be your interest. Then only you can take it forward from it. So that's a way where we have to connect and then move ahead from end to end, a lot of the passions and then where your mission, then where you love it, and then where you paid for that, right? Ultimately, the money is the one that will give you motivations, and then it will take you to the next level. The CISO portfolio, always the CISO will have a multiple portfolio from end to end in terms of IoT, in terms of overall cybersecurity areas. It covers from cybersecurity operation, security enablement, of course, including the budgeting, security architectures, identity management, and all the ways. So as a CISO, where we need a 360 degree view of protection, knowledge, and then cost, technologies, and process, and then overall enforcements of the controls. This is on the career sites in the bigger bit. Anyway, since running short of time, just I'm giving the glimpses. I have put it a four level of portfolios. The leftmost top, you can see the yearly career in terms of cybersecurity with IoT, what are the things you can do. Mid-level career, what are the things you can do it, and the late career, what are the things you can do it. Similarly, on the extended at top level, what are the things you can do? And the cybersecurity plus IoT plus overall A and then ML from the end to end. Just I'll give you small stuff actually. That will give a lot of the visibility in terms of POCs. What are the things really we can take it forward? So this will give a little bit insights in terms of how.
There is a question. Is there any math involved in cybersecurity? The role of math and how to start with hands-on? These are all the two questions.
Great. So this is a two-way, right? It's not a mathematical, right? See, it's one of the forum one of the senior folks, he told cybersecurity is a lot of stress. You have to put a lot of effort day and night, and then you lose your you know, the personal time and all the things and all. But then other view where we have given is you get a lot of time, you get a lot of you know, the effort, and then you can put a lot of you know, ideologies to penetrate and then take it forward. So this is how you take it. So if you feel that is a, you know, very hectic, or if you feel it's not comfortable, then your passion is not towards that, right? Some people, they are very good at Max. If you go and ask them, was you got bored of Max? Definitely not, right? Because they like it. That's what their passion. So the first and foremost thing is we have to identify what we love it is. It's very important. So that's the cybersecurity. It's you know, the catwalk if you like it. If you have a little bit the base knowledge of in terms of, it is very simple, right? If you have a TCP, yeah, if you have applications, very clear. If you know this, where and all the sectors it has been used, what is the purpose? What are the possibility of hacking where we can do it? From there, we can give it. Of course, we are doing a lot of mentoring also for the students as well as other professionals. There's a company called Sybase, where we are connecting and we are giving a lot of guidance in terms of how do we build their career in cybersecurity. So that's the way cybersecurity itself, as I have mentioned slides, we have n number of portfolios, really, you know, whether you want to be in compliance, you want it in applications, or you want to be in process, or you want it in identity, there's some many portfolios. So really we have to understand what your interest, your passion, your ability, and then where you will, let us take, you are so extrovert, you are talking so nicely, just connect to the people just like that, right? I mean, during that time, we can't put you into the any application testing or something, right? Because that is purely focused on the application. That role, they can take a compliance, because compliance guys really, he has to talk with the multiple people. Just he has to connect quickly like that, actually, right? So that's a way where we, your personality also is very important. So this from my standpoint, where I'm doing a lot of mentoring, where we are doing a lot of board of studies for the multiple universities and colleges, where we give our insights like how do we touch cybersecurity based on your passion, interest, and your nature. You know? That's always, we do that. Of course, we can connect to one-to-one, or maybe you can follow me on the LinkedIn where I can, you know, suggest about that. I believe I answered you know, your questions. Are you able to see my screen, Lakshmi?
Yes, sir. Google search engine, it is available.
Amazing. So this is now, as I have mentioned, just we are going to hack a CCTV camera of a couple of countries. I didn't want to disclose the name, but how really they have given, what are the possibilities they have it, what are the things we can do it. Just, you know, I'm not doing any hacking tool or nothing. Just I'm putting, so one of the, you know, the possibilities of vendors, and then what are the things it's possible, how we can take it forward. So just I'm putting in title, EvokeCoM is you know, the product name where I'm taking. And really just I wanted to see that this kind of brand of camera, wherever it is, of course, all the cameras are well connected over the internet, right? So just I'm connecting to the webcam. And EvokeCoM HTML page where I can get it. It has a lot of IPs from end to end. Just I'm opening this respective IPs. Very simple, right? I'm able to see the Tesla car parked over there. I can see what they are opening in the boot. What are the things they are loading? It's like a different locations camera where we are able to see that. Different country. But we're not using any tool at all. That's what I'm saying. How the devices are well connected, how the devices are protected also, it's very important. Here, just you know, it's like a camera one, just I'm changing as a camera two. It has a multiple camera, right? Just I'm seeing as a camera two, where I'm able to see their lawn area in the same hotel where they are discussing. That's what, whenever you open your laptop in the hotel and the restaurant, you should be very cautious. Which side you are sitting, which side you are, you know, seeing the stuff from, you know, the end to the end. because it's like a viewable, right? The entire thing, so that I can see from end to end. This is the entire parking area, whatever. You may see the CCTV, but absolutely some third eyes watching you across all the regions or maybe wherever it is. We may think it's only organizations where the hotel they have hosted, only those people are watching, but it's not the case, right? It can be leaked out from anywhere else if the device is not protected in the, you know, the well manner. So that's a way of, you know, CCTV cameras and all, just like that, where we can take a CCTV, not only CCTV, where we can take a TV itself on the remote world having the public IPs, and then how we can, you know, or take it forward. This again, it's a different camera. The camera is not the over there. Again, back to, you know, camera one, where we have a Tesla or whatever it is. This, they have put it as a charging, you know, or the unit kind of stuff actually. Not just I'm getting into the one more camera, which gives overall street lights, right? The entire street, whatever the camera I have it, I'm able to see that. I can see the people, you know, the parking, as well as I can create a pattern, right? If the red car is moving morning 9 o'clock, I can see that every day morning 9 o'clock, this car is moving this direction. So who are all walking these areas, right? So I can watch the entire, you know, the movement of these people, the kids is moving with the walking. So all the things can be, you know, the monitor. Really are not used much tools and technology, but it's like on the open system itself where we have a lot of vulnerabilities where we can move ahead and then, you know, take it forward. This is one of the, you know, the hotel inside where we are looking, where their working area, right? Their office working area where we are seeing what are the things they have it and then how we can, you know, take it forward actually. So that's a way, it's on the little bit of the bigger way, how we can take it forward. So really we have a number of cameras. Really it has a lot of vulnerabilities, a lot of challenges, and where we can monitor, where we can control, where we can exploit, and where we can bring out the entire data and we can keep it open, right? So you may be in hotel, right? Maybe you're just, it's like a small scam. You got married, you know, but you have extramarital. You are in the hotel, you are having some food or somewhere else. Those camera video clippings can be sent to your wife, you know, just like that, where we can send it to your wife. So that's why it can be, put it on the, you know, different directions, Barandal, there is a possibility, and then Barandal where we can have a, you know, the complete attack from overall organizations. That's what system I have given. This is, if you see here, I have given overall industry landscapes from end to end. What are the market in terms of IoT? Who are all the people in terms of threat intelligence? Who are the vendor who is really working very hard in terms of behavioral detections? Who are all the people who are there? And then the quantum, because nowadays the quantum encryption is one coming to the pictures. But of course, it takes some more time in terms of processing and all the things and all. But however, things are picking up and you know, moving ahead actually. Great. So if you have any questions or something, I love to take questions for a few minutes. Already I have other call also. But however, you know, I can take a few questions and then you know, we can, you know, conclude.
So yeah, this is, dear participants, it's allowed to unmute and you can communicate. Yeah.
Yeah. Before proceeding, no, this Richard's a very great note actually, right? This is always I take. Before we get to know this note, always I take. You know, if someone offers amazing opportunity and you are not sure, like, you know, whether you can do it or not, straight away you can say is yes. Then you can learn it. You know, always in the day-to-day life, you know, you cannot do anything. First you learn and then do, you know, the stuff. It won't work at all. Just you accept, put your best effort to reach it, right? Then things will, you know, move over there actually. So in terms of, you know, today's session also, I was into different situations, but since I committed really, you know, I want to come out from this medical stuff and, you know, I want to give the things to the things because I'm committed, right? Whatever it is I want to, because I have, you know, other dependency, plus 150 plus people, you know, they are in the systems and really I should be having the handshake. So that's a commitment by default, you know, it comes to you and then we can, you know, take it forward. Yeah, please go ahead. If anyone have any questions, maybe 2 to 3 questions we can take. If you don't get anything, just you can mail me or you can...
Even, sir, if you're asking for your mail ID, if you have the slide that you can display, maybe later part only they would have joined the session. They were asking for your contact details. That is one thing I have come across in the chat window.
Great, okay.
Then other than that, participants, you please unmute yourself and you can interact whichever you wish to communicate. Yeah,
this is my detail. You can ping me on navneethanm@gmail.com. That's my ID. But LinkedIn is always I'll be inactive. That's a navneethanm. You know, if you ping on navneethanm, you can see the snapshot or you can take the QR code, whatever I have it. This is my ID. Definitely, you know, we can connect and then take it forward. Always, I love to learn from you all, as well as I'm happy to share whatever I have gained in the last 2 decades. We love to, you know, take it forward. So great. So we have any other questions or something?
As of now, there is no question, sir.
Amazing. So this is one more interesting note, right? Always, you know, you have to choose a boss. You know, one side you have amazing opportunity. I don't know. I think most of the people you would have recognized. But if you have a right boss at you know, your level, he will skill you at you know, the right way actually. So always choosing, you know, whoever it is, right? Choosing the right mentor is very important. Always we should not think about like we know this everything, we can take it forward. Really, we need a right boss at the office is very important because he will give a comfort zone. He will take you where you have to take you in the tight rope and then where you have to leave the rope, right? So that's why he will mold you in the right things. So always the choosing the right boss is very important, right? The boss that supports you, trusts you and believes in you and will make a great difference in your career. So you have to choose the right boss and then, you know, take it forward. So amazing. So always, I strongly believe, right? Positively, with the more confident determinations, always be like an eagle. You know that, right? The eagle, so other people do not know, if there is a rain, it's coming to there, they will go for their nest. They go for their shadow. But you know that, right? The eagle will go beyond the cloud. That's what it is, the power of eagle. That's what always the problem comes. Always things will, you know, keep moving. But don't look for any shadows. Always, you know, you think about how you can fly on the sky beyond the problem and then play over that and then give the stuff. I'm sure, I think you might have heard the story of a banyan tree, right? How many of you like banyan trees? You can raise a hand, maybe I can take you know, content. How many of you like banyan trees? Just a simple analogy, right? You can say yes or no, or you can raise a hand. How many of you really, you know, shown that the banyan trees? I couldn't count it, but I'll take it as close to more than 50%.
Few responses are coming from chat and a few are raising hand. Navaneethan, sir, there is a question. Role of your job and how difficult it is, sir. They were curious to know about your role and your responsibility in the field of cybersecurity.
No, it's a very interesting role. That's no second thought. Very interesting role. Only thing is the time management, right? Because I study a lot, I read a lot, I speak a lot, and then I give a lot of input to the, you know, the many people. That's my nature, right? When you're doing the college days, like 20 years back, I love to study a lot. And then during the semesters, always, you know, we study one day before. So I have the capability where I can, if you take that's a concept called the LIC. Just I have done my engineering in electronics. Just I'm giving the example. If you study this entire paper, it's very difficult and complicated. So my analogy is, I'll study the entire paper, I'll give the abstract to the people, you know. So the people who are listening, they may not require to read through the entire, you know, the books or whatever. They go and write and then they clear, they scored more than 70. So that's the way it is. In terms of my passions, my, you know, thought process, really I like reading. I really curious. See, what are the slides I have put it together? It's really on from my heart. Really, what are the things I have, you know, yearned it, and then what are things where really I wanted to move ahead. I have a lot of determinations, you know, in terms of how we wanted to give it. Always there'll be a plus minus. always there is a people who is pointing your fingers and all the things. But you have to focus. It's what really it's good for you. You have to make it forward. But the one most thing is really the time is a little bit is more important, where we need more time on your early stages. As well as you are committed, right? If you take a security, the entire organization is depending on you. So you should be well committed to the organizations. If anything, it may not be a 9-to-6 job. You may get a call at 9, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. There is a hacking. There is something. It's like just we have to get up and then, on the instance, we should be able to provide a solutions, right? The hackers will have, as I told, 1,000 times they may do the attack. But as a defender, we should have a complete 1,000 times how we are going to protect. All 1,000 attacks might be the different dimensions, right? So we need that kind of determinations. And of course, it's everybody have it. But only thing is, we have to put time, we should not give up. That's the only stuff where I can give it. But I enjoy my role. What are the things? I enjoy the 2 hours what I'm spending. Really, I'm enjoying. I'm so happy to give it back to you, like whatever I know. Similarly, I'm so happy to take it from you. Right? That's a pleasure. I have it. If you teach with that, or if you start journey with on those notes, then absolutely it'd be an amazing one. Great. I believe you have an answer, but of course, in detail we can discuss. So the banyan trees, no, I'll tell you the banyan, just maybe with that story, I'll conclude. The banyan tree special is, you would have seen the banyan tree, it's very high to wide, the root also, it goes very depth. It will have a lot of branches across that, right? So if you take 100 people, if there's a heavy rain, 100 people can go and stand under the banyan trees, right? That's the power of the banyan tree. So in terms of a yearly stage, you should not be in the comfort zone. You should not be in the banyan trees. Because if the banyan tree, it covers all the way, but it won't give you the sunlight. It won't give you the water. It won't give you the things what you wanted to have it. Because you are the plant, right? You would have seen it, right? Near the banyan tree, you would have might not seen much plants. Because there's no water, there's no sunlight. It's not much of the airflow. Because all the things it is taken there by the banyan trees. So we should be there. We should get that. We can be, grow up close to the banyan trees. We can see the banyan tree, how they have grown up, and then the same analogy we can apply. If you are outside, you can stand by your own. You can stand by your, you will get a direct water. You will get a direct sunlight. You will get a direct, the air. Then you can grow up on the different way. That's the way we have to design our life, how, we can take it forward. So with this note, really, I believe this last 2 hours session might be useful. It may not be 100%, but definitely in some corner, some thought, or maybe from your research area, you would have striked it. Okay, this is the area really industry side it's picking up. This are the area really I can start a career. These are the real challenges it's happening and how we can, move it forward actually. So with this, I'm concluding my note and leave it to Lakshmi. Lakshmi, you have any other thought, over to you.
Yes, sir. Almost it went well, both technical and motivational way. As usual, the way you drive the session, this is with our institution. It is second time we are hearing to you. And thank you for accepting the session in spite of your busy schedule, in spite of your board meetings, a lot of setbacks. You have come forward and engaged the session. Since it is 2 hours, we cannot do beyond that also. So that also the fact.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah, down the lines, we have a maybe one day workshops kind of stuff. So we'll do many stuff. It's real time. I can give a real time hacking, but really they should be familiar with the, tools and technology. So always we should say, without understanding the ABCD, without framing the words, really we can't write an essay, right? So we need what does mean A, what does mean B? And similarly, on the basics level, I'm saying that. I mean, not so basic, but however, I should tell what is E, and then how I should tell you with the A, I can frame apple. Then with the apple, I can say that as apple is red, and then apple is healthy. Then with that, I can write essay, right? So that's the way things will, establish.
Yes, sir. Well said. Thank you for your acceptance and being with us and delivering your insights. I thank participants. Although many dropouts, still there are 62 members available, 62 to 63 members available with us. Thank you for your active participation. Many express that the sessions are good, Navaneethan sir. Many and many comments have come to you. So with that note, I would like to conclude, say safe and have a nice day, Navaneethan sir. And tomorrow, let us join by 10 o'clock with two different resource persons tomorrow as well, morning one and afternoon one. So with that note, let me conclude. Have a good evening. Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for having me here. And,
thank you so much, sir.
All the participants.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, sir.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Navaneethan, sir. Excellent presentation.
Amazing. Thank you so much. It's my pleasure.
Thank you for accepting our college invitation for this.
Ashok program. Kumar Nanda, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Our NASCOM coordinator, Dr. Ashok Kumar Nanda, is online. Navaneethan, sir. To whom?
Yeah, you know, I'm able to recognize the voice actually. Yeah.
A feedback link is shared. Participants, you can make use of it. Another half an hour, it will be kept open. Nothing to worry. You can make a note of it. Thank you all.
I can say to all my here the participants, whoever presented, that I can appeal for you that SAR is an excellent resource person related to the cyber security. He is the second time he's giving the speech here. Earlier, I also invited him for the students' point of the webinar. He got also more feedback, good feedbacks from the participants. He's an excellent resource person for cyber security. But he is very busy person.
Yeah, as I told you, management is a bigger way. We'll have 360 degree issues in all the ways. But definitely, I'm glad to share thought and take it forward.
Dear participants, I can say that about him, that he has 21 certifications, which is recognized in globally IT industries. And he is a CISO now, and his career, if you go through website, then you can learn how his life is wonderful. That means how much he has struggled for the cyber security, and also he achieved his position. He is a very deterministic and also well planned in his career. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for the honor. Have a great day ahead. Thank you so much. We'll take it forward. Maybe we connect in further sessions. See you all.
One second. Thank you so much, sir.
Thanks a lot.
Participant, I am going to end the meeting. So once if I end it, you can't note it down the feedback form link. Kindly note it. I am going to end the meeting.